Doc.
Hey, well, look. Look how I can jump.
Boingy, 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 boingy.
Welcome back, modded
Where
Minecraft.
Where are we? We've got our capes on.
Oh, yeah. Woo-hoo. Check it out. Welcome to ForgeCraft. The place by modders, for modders, and other special guests. That's
yes,
us, man.
I guess. That means us. We're special.
Look at that wolf. He's AFKing. Look at his nano suit. Whatever he wears there, that's crazy. And he's got a cape. Special one.
Yep.
But not as cool as the Minecons.
Yeah, is that like last year's cape?
Nah, it's a red one. I think it's a cheaty cape.
Or
it's the Pahycraft. Pahycraft. Pahycraft special cape. So let's see what's going on here. You are in Spawn Village. If you want to get started, get to the workshop to the east. The workshop also contains public access machines. Oh, they are rigged. What else is there?
Yep. We have Mistcraft. So we don't have that on our server.
Nope. Cool. The Digger Mistcraft HI. I see. That's crazy. Yeah, the cool thing is, guys, on here, there are some mods available already that are not released to the public yet. This is the test server of the modders themselves. And Direwolf over here, who's AFKing at the moment, he's quickly doing a phone call, and we thought we used the time to make our introduction here. And yeah, we got invited as a special guest up there.
Yep. And we just want to check the place out, maybe get some cool tips, see what else the modders are working on, and also, you know, best of all, see what they build with their own mods, which I'm sure, you know, a lot of this stuff is crazy, I bet.
Yep, that should be really interesting for you guys, we thought. And yeah, with our modded Minecraft series, just talked to Slowpoke. He said now Red Power is super, super close within the next week, potentially. But yeah, we will see. And as soon as that comes out, we can hit the road and start building our base in our modded Minecraft series. But yeah, we just want to wait for the Red Power. Without that, it just doesn't feel right to us, right?
Yep, yeah. All of our machines really use Red Power, so it would kind of break everything.
And there would be terrain generation. And quickly want to address this with the Hermitcraft or Minecraft FTP. Well, the maps need to be resetted anyways, you know, because we don't have the Red Power terrain generation in there. That is volcanoes, that is marble, that is other stuff. So, yeah, in any case, either we have to go exploring really far, but if you want to have the cool terrain and I don't want to miss out on volcanoes, it's just worth waiting. And, yeah, today, some interesting stuff for you in any case. So, let's wait for Direwolf. And then we hit the road on here.
Sounds good. Check out this epic beacon, man. Speed 2, haste, strength, jump boost, resistance.
Yeah. You got it all. Full beacon buff here right at the start. That's how I like it.
All right. So, guys, we're just hanging out. This is the spawn village. This is basically where we all spawned in. Nice little village right here. We kind of started off the whole series. We've got... Right around the spawn village is just basically just some farms and stuff. Nothing too interesting or exciting, except for this building. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, that looks awesome. The Hall of Knowledge. I saw that already.
the blocks here,
massive beacon.
Yeah,
the blocks here are from a mod called Zycraft. It's an in-development mod. There's really not much to it aside from some world generation going on.
Yeah.
It's still in progress. It's being worked on. It's coming out soon. But this is mainly our enchanting room. Just has all that stuff.
Cool.
So do these blocks do something special, or are they just...
These are just for decoration. There will be a bunch of machines. It's a technical mod, so there's going to be all kinds of machines and power and energy. I can even cheat in a couple items just to show you what his energy net looks like. It's actually really impressive looking.
Cool.
Yeah, we can check that out in a little bit.
What is that crystal there in the middle of the room? There's some kind of a...
Oh, yeah, that's gem. Also from Zycraft. Yep. Yep, those crystals will be used for some stuff. And over here, by the way, there's a little stairwell that leads down around the back here.
Oh, hidden. Hidden stuff. That's good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The secret laboratory.
All the way to the bottom.
I might just adjust my brightness a bit. Video set. Yeah, brightness. Put it up a bit.
Oh, yeah.
Everything resets. We just installed that. That's a secret mod package. We can't give it out because there's lots of mods in there in development. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, we have to keep it private. Hoo-ah.
Yep.
Oh, farms built by Covert Jaguar and Irish Dragon. Oh, what do we have here?
Skeleton farms.
Yep.
We like that, cool. Monkey?
Yeah.
Here, step on in and stay inside this little room. And then once you're inside the room here, Doc M, don't stand out there. That's the dangerous spot.
Oh, I thought in this room. I thought.
Flip the lever here.
Okay. Flick. Oh, did it do something?
Did it work?
I know it did.
It's a little cozy in here.
Yeah. Oh. Now push the button behind you.
Oh, yeah. What? Where?
Oh. I don't fall there.
It's all
nice.
What happened? I missed it. I always missed the good stuff. Oh, we burned them.
The little cookers, yeah.
Yep, it lights them on fire. It weakens them, so they die within one or two hits.
Ah. Oh, that's pretty cool. What are these blocks here? Just igniters?
Yeah, they're igniters. Yeah. They're from Red
Bull. Yeah, we use these with our cow cooker, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Dyer, by the way, we used a skeleton-powered cake machine. I don't know if you saw that.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Ah, you can also make or move spawners. How did you get all the spawners in here, or is it just for demonstration purposes?
We found them all in the world. There's a mod right now that we recently installed called Soul Shards.
Mm-hmm.
And what it is, it allows you to craft an item that can collect the souls of enemies that you kill. And after you collect 200 of the same souls, you can create a mob spawner with it.
Oh, man, that's freaking amazing.
Crazy.
Yeah.
There's
actually 5 levels of spawner, and each level requires 200 souls each.
Wow, that totally makes sense. That would make spawn collection. You know, that would I would love to have that in real Minecraft.
It's really neat.
Wow.
And the top tier spawner like spawns like 7 mobs a second. It's crazy.
Ooh, man,
it's tons of them.
Sounds lovely. Okay, yep. So here's a lot of farming prototypes. That's amazing, Monkey. We need to do that, man. When we have our mod pack up and running. Oh, what's that cool book here?
Are we going to have that in ours?
We need to get it.
We will.
Very good.
Which mod did you say it was?
It's called Soul Shards.
We need to get that. That's so amazing. All right, so
here is... probably don't want to follow that book. That's probably going to be dangerous. It's probably a wither farm on the other side, but that's a Mistcraft book. I'll show you guys what Mistcraft is all about in a moment. Let's go upstairs and... go check out some more areas around the spawn.
Oh, yeah.
Looks Mistcraft cool. is cool. You guys don't have Mistcraft either, I guess, huh?
Nope.
Yep.
So
I don't think so.
The dark blocks, that was basalt stairs, wasn't that? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, probably. Yep. Yeah. Cool.
Wow.
And then if we head off this direction, you'll see kind of our shared resources and machine area.
Mm-hmm.
What we built is like right outside spawn is just a big area where everybody can use like the machines and the resources separate from their own base. Like a lot of people built their own base with machines and stuff, but this is just a nice way for anybody who's new to the server to kind of get started. You can see there's a lot of machines and contraptions in here.
Hello.
Yep. That's Player. He's one of the main developers for Industrial Craft, by the way.
Ah, awesome.
Yep.
We are
guys,
back.
We're back.
Yep.
Yeah, little cut here. Frame rates were a bit low, so we adjusted our settings. So we wanted to go down to the engine room, Dio, right?
Yeah, there's some engines down here I thought you guys might like to check out.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
This is where the magic happens.
Yeah.
Wow. This room's pretty much powering everything that happens. We've got a railcraft item called a steam boiler here.
Wow.
And you have to give it fuel and water, and it'll create steam for you. And you can see the steam flowing through those golden pipes.
Yeah, that's pretty epic, flowing all over. And it goes into, what are these steam engines here?
Yep. Yeah. They're generating buildcraft power.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh. That's cool.
So you guys have made like fuel and oil and all that stuff, right? This is just another way to do it. You can do it with steam if you want.
Wow, and this blue beam is the energy that gets...
Yep.
Wow, that's crazy. And what are those pipes transporting the energy?
Those are powered pipes. You guys don't have those? You should have those.
Yeah, we have those, the redstone.
But we haven't used them like that. That looks pretty impressive. It looks like...
we haven't used any yet.
Yeah, the man with the golden colt, you know that? Scaramanga, the James Bond movie. He had this, the Solex. Ah, yeah, whatever. Yeah, let's keep on going.
We've got a little bug going on here. Like I said, this is a beta test server, so some of the mods we beta test. I think some of these carts are duplicating here. Mm. What is this all about? Oh, boy.
Can you have diamonds in them and duplicate them? Because we need some diamonds still.
What are these machines here? Oh, what is that?
Oh, yeah, look at that. Okay. And I'm back. I had to make a quick cut there because I think my client crashed when I broke that cart. Yeah, don't break a cart. Your client will crash.
No, okay. We'll attach it.
Yep. So, these are some of the farms. If we go up here, you should be able to see some of like the farms. Like you guys have made the we have a couple peat farms and a couple tree farms going on.
Yeah. There's a bunch of peat coming through
Our beloved peat. That's
we use those rail cars to transport it.
That's the good. That's cool. Oh. Yeah. Ah, yeah, we know that. Oh, but yours looks way cooler. What the hell?
I'm actually going to set it to daytime because it's better for recording.
What's that? Yeah, what's this
big box here?
Oh, this is another railcraft item. Oh. Basically, it creates water.
Oh.
It's a water. It's a water tank. It it just generates water out of the atmosphere.
Oh. Yep. And you got two hoppers on top there. What are these doing here in that situation? Why hoppers?
Just to collect the excess, like as it creates bog earth, it just stores the excess in the hoppers.
Ah, that makes sense. So you can add these as some kind of a buffer.
Yep.
In there. Ah, I understand. Wow.
Extra filler tank kind of. Yeah. Awesome.
That's really cool. Yeah, this is the farming area.
We don't have hoppers yet, I don't think.
Yeah, I don't think you do either now.
And what are these things here? Man, everywhere you look, you see crazy stuff. It's amazing.
This is a infernal furnace. This thing here. This is a Thaumcraft item. I'll show you guys some Thaumcraft stuff. Ooh. Pretty cool.
Look at that. How cool it looks, man.
It's got a little thing on the top here, and I just drop items into the top, and it'll smelt them and spit them out the front.
Wow, that's cool. Oh, I like that. That's really fantasy. Oh, that's awesome.
Thaumcraft is like all about magic, and it's a really neat mod.
Yeah. Place iron block here for dark iron. Ooh.
Yeah, that's another mod that does a little bit of different stuff. That's called factorization. It's somewhat newish, I think, and that'll create some dark iron. It's pretty
like
cool.
Disneyland here, right? Monkey Farm. We've been there quite.
Yep.
Too bad you couldn't make it to the Minecon, Dire.
Oh, I know. Amazing. I was so bummed. Yeah, I really wanted to go over
there. Oh, R2-D2. Oh, no. Well, what's in here? That's the room. Oh, yeah. I wanted to ask about these red things on the wall, man. Those are like, we're totally... What is that?
That is from Buildcraft. Those are... you know those gates that we saw downstairs? Mm-hmm. That's the way that you can make them. Using it's called an assembly table, and it uses like lasers and stuff.
Holy freaker.
Yeah, it's pretty
neat.
Stand
back, monkey. I'm going to hide behind you just to be safe.
Let's do this.
Let the ooh.
Yep.
Can it hurt you? Can't get in there. Okay.
They won't hurt. But it's the further back table there. You can see it's turning redstone into these redstone chipsets.
So is the laser powering it, or what is it actually doing?
The laser is kind of doing the work. It's kind of like like circuit table type thing. So imagine like the laser is etching the circuits.
Wow, that is pretty freaking cool.
Oh yeah, it's neat. That's another Buildcraft one.
What's that? Oh, that's an anvil.
That's just a vanilla thing, believe it or not. We have a couple.
Oh my god, what is this?
Yeah. Oh, and here, courtesy of Alex and Dyer. What is that? Is that your secret stash here?
Oh yeah, that's an item for Mistcraft.
Ooh.
Which I'll show you some Mistcraft stuff pretty soon.
Yeah.
Here, let's go out this way and check out some of the railcraft tanks.
Oh, there's somebody. I thought it was. Also part of a mod. Okay. Oh, you so got you guys a water seen the built tank?
Tanks that can store liquids and stuff? Mm-hmm. These are railcraft tanks right in this room.
Oh, they look sweet.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I like these.
Either 3x3, 5x5, or 7x7. Mm. And the bigger you build them, the bigger they'll be inside.
So I assume this holds a lot more than those little glass tanks that we make.
Yeah, these guys will hold 720 buckets.
Mm.
Wow.
The 3x3x5 version. I think the biggest size you can have is like 9x9x8.
And that can hold like, and I like the look. They look cool.
Yep. This was my contribution. I built this room. And the room underneath was me trying to be really compact and do like 20 different things in one small space. So it's going to be very confusing, and I apologize for that.
Sure looks like it. Oh, but it looks cool.
Yeah, but I'm pretty much creating all those liquids up there in this room, doing like a bunch of different things.
Wow. That's sweet.
Yeah, so you're it was creating... like, let's see how compact and crazy we can be.
So how are you getting it? Are you using like equivalent exchange stuff, or what are you?
Nope.
Where are you getting everything?
Now just supplying it through different means. There's some stuff that's forestry bees related. These blocks that I'm walking on here are another railcraft item called a coke oven. They create that creosote oil stuff, which is used for rails and railcraft.
Wow. Yep. This is
so sick. The only pipes I see anything in are, what is this, fuel right here?
Yep. Yeah. So I haven't, there's nothing running right now that's doing much else. Like if I were to put some items in here, it would create more different items and stuff.
Oh, so you have to come in here and fill some items and then it will create the fuel. Okay, got it.
Yeah.
So it's not just automatically running on its own.
Nope.
Without, okay.
Now, once you supply the item, it'll do whatever it needs to do to convert it into the liquid automatically, but like seeds or oil or something like that.
Man, I dig that lava tank. That could be just a light outside of a big castle or something.
Yeah, yeah, that's cool.
Looks really cool. You gotta love bee wax and stuff here. Why is all the bee stuff here? Do you have bees close by, or can you can produce it in here?
Relatively close by. Here, come on outside. I'll show you where I get my bee products from.
Ah.
Yeah, we haven't done much to our we tackled the beehives a little bit, and you know, that was about it. We didn't do much with it though.
Yeah, we bred them and crossbred them. Oh, here's
one of those turtles. I've written some programs on my turtles to do stuff. Turtles are neat. They're from computer craft, and you can write code if you're like any good. Like it's real simple scripting language.
Yeah,
and you can have your turtles do different things for you. They're like little robots in the world.
Oh, run!
So I wrote a program.
It can't run.
Turtle, find me diamonds.
Collect.
You can do that if you
write it. Collect bees program. Okay, let's start it. That's cool.
There he goes.
He goes flying now?
Yeah, he flies around. He runs on coal, so he'll he'll find the way to the bee stuff.
That's amazing, man.
He's pretty neat. He'll go. He has a little inventory, so he can pick items out of chests or other inventories, and he'll pick up the bee products and then bring them back here and deposit them in this block where they'll get sent through the system.
Monkey Farm. We'd be sitting in a freaking chair with our little turtles in front of us and typing in commands. Yep. We will not place a block ourselves in our new world.
Yep.
Just let a bunch of these things fly around. We just need coal.
Lay back, drinking in a cocktail. Having the turtles do our work for us.
Yeah.
Oh, it's great. Look, turtles are fun. Have us. I have a lot of fun with them.
Oh, yeah.
We've got some crazy trees back here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Some rubber trees and stuff.
Yeah.
Yep. And the bees stuff is way in the distance over there.
So your turtle's just going to fly off and do his thing?
Needs.
Go get her, boy. Go get her. Amazing. The blue portals here, is that also Mistcraft?
Yep, that's Mistcraft too. So
are the different worlds Mistcraft? You know, the ones with the different sky colors and all of that?
Yeah.
What was that? Okay.
Yep, that's Mistcraft related. Yep. So if we go this way, I'll show you some Mistcraft dimensions, and I'll show you my house too.
Oh yeah.
This is my house here. So Mistcraft allows you to create other dimensions. So like in vanilla Minecraft, you just have the Nether. Mistcraft lets you create like pretty much unlimited number of dimensions.
Cool.
There is a limit, but it's like 2.1 billion. So I say it's unlimited.
Yeah, that's kind of unlimited.
Yeah, so you can create your own worlds and stuff. So this is my room. This is like my inventory chest room.
I'm gonna be so nosy and gonna have a look what you have there.
That's cool. Yeah.
Red size shorium block. I can't even read it. Monazit or cinnabar or what the heck? Quartz crystal. That sounds kind of normal. Aluminium, alright. Holy. Wow. Rubber and scrap. Oh, UU matter.
Yep. And all the processing and sorting happens downstairs here.
Oh, here's some mechanical parts. You're loaded, man.
Thank you.
Lucky, you got the good stuff in there.
Yep, I got all the diamonds. Let's go.
Good job.
Yeah. So what, is this some kind of crafting bench? What do we have here?
Yeah,
this is a barrel from Factorization. Oh, okay. They can hold 64 stacks of one item. So they can only hold one item type at a time. Mm. Go ahead and left click on the barrel.
Mm. Oops.
Yep, and then right click to put the item in.
Sweet.
Is that neat?
Yeah. Yep.
So it's a real nice way to store a bunch of different types of items, you know. And it's really nice when you're using, like, the piping system here. So these are red power pneumatic.
That's awesome. When you're building, you know, you just go there, right-click, bam, get another stack, go.
Yep.
Really cool. Yeah, that is fun as well.
Yeah.
Huh. Slowpoke was here.
Oh, hey, Slowpoke. Totally.
He'll be on. He said he'd come hang out with you guys. He'll be on probably either later this episode or next episode.
Cool.
So what is your gate doing here? I really want to flip the switch, but I don't want to break anything.
Oh, no, it's okay. The gate's actually broken at the moment. Okay. It's not doing anything.
Well, never mind.
This is just a mass fabricator. It makes the UU matter.
Mm. Oh, we haven't had one of these.
Yeah, that is cool. Have you seen Ender Chests?
We know but the color-coded ones, right?
Yeah, that's the this mod existed before Ender Chests were added to vanilla Minecraft.
Yeah.
Basically, there's three colors on the top.
Yeah.
And you can right-click each little tab with a die.
Oh, that's nicely
done.
And
every chest that is on the same color frequency shares the same inventory.
Ah.
Cool.
Yep.
Yeah, they pretty didn't neat. Want to introduce the full functionality of that into the actual game. But that's pretty cool.
Yeah. And then over here is where I'm generating all my power for my industrial craft.
Look at that.
Dang, look at that thing. Yeah. That is a lot of lava right there.
We just love these lava tanks.
Here, let me drain some power and then I'll show you guys how it works.
For some reason, we always loved our lava tanks. Why is that so fascinating?
A tank full of lava you can't beat.
Yeah.
So this here is a tank cart. It's a railcraft cart that can hold liquids.
Mm.
So if you right-click on it, you'll see it's probably draining out a little bit just because my generators are running right now.
Mm-hmm.
The block under it, if you look right underneath the tank cart, you'll see there's a little block there. That's where it's draining into.
Mm.
And then we use the Billcraft pipes to transport the lava into the tank.
Oh, that's neat. So it can
send... Liquid unloader?
Yep.
Oh, pretty sweet. So you can send minecarts around with lava and all kinds of liquids. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then
what is that
what
thing
it does
here?
Is,
where does it go? Like, here is that stopper.
Yeah. So what this thing does is the tank cart, when it's empty, the liquid unloader emits a redstone signal,
mm-hmm.
which activates the railcraft track under it. It's like a power track underneath it.
Yeah.
And then it
so only when it's empty, it'll you send it through this portal here?
Yep.
And where does the portal go?
Here, let me get just a couple empty buckets just to speed this along real quick. I think I can do this.
Now it's draining. That is cool.
Yep. It's pretty neat. Here, I'll just drain it most of the way, and then we'll see when it's really empty. So it's almost there. And when it's empty, it'll zip along.
I can see it here. empty, and off it goes.
Yep, and we can go follow him if we want.
Let's go. Ooh, that was scary.
So this is the opposite of a liquid unloader. It's a liquid loader, and you can see it's draining liquid into the minecart.
So you're getting lava from the nether, of course. Very good place.
Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh.
Yeah, endless supply almost. Look at that.
Yeah.
Wow.
You can see it pumping a lot of the stuff out.
So much things to see here.
Has anybody ever emptied the nether?
Yeah. Of lava? Chicken Bones did once. He's the guy who makes NEI. He definitely built a machine on our last server that just completely decimated the nether.
The lava looks pretty impressive. It looks like stormy weather, you know, but lava style.
It's really cool looking when it's all drained out like that.
Wow. I love the nether here.
Yep. And then what the liquid loader does is when it completely fills the tank, again, it does a redstone signal on the powered track underneath, and it'll send the minecart back to my base.
Sweet. That's pretty cool.
Yep.
Wow. So, guys, I think we have to check the time. There's so much things we have to see here. We might come back after a little cut, guys. We have to check how long the episode is already.
Sure.
I don't want to stop. I want to keep on going. It's crazy.
Oh, yeah. You haven't seen nothing yet.
All right.
All right. We'll be back in a few, guys. All right. We are back from our little cut there, and I think it's about time to wrap up, I think. Right, guys?
Yeah. We already, like, over 25 minutes. We don't want to make too long of the episodes, but look at these things. We want to show you these. Wow. What the heck?
He has a little gift for me.
They're cute little guys. They're called golems, and they're from Thaumcraft 3, which just came out publicly yesterday, by the way. Yeah, that's a cauldron. You don't want to jump in that.
Yeah.
It's a hot cauldron, obviously. Yep. Wow. What are these things
too
doing?
Too hot for a steam bath.
Oh, I'll show you guys what
they're
do.
They're filling the jars, right? He has little jars of this stuff.
Wow. Yeah, let him run. Let him do something.
Sure. Here, I'll put this golem that I have in my hand here. It's called a wooden golem.
Yeah.
And I'm going to place him on this chest right behind you, Doc.
Ooh. Don't jinx me.
Now drop your dirt on the ground. Just anywhere.
Oh.
No, just drop it like an item.
Oh, well, aren't you a little productive little piece of wood?
Oh.
He's like a puppy fetching.
Dude, I want to have one of these.
Yep. These are from Thaumcraft. Golems are meant to just be like little laborers for you. They can do a bunch of different things. There's some golems that will empty a chest. They'll fill a chest. These guys over here are keeping my cauldron taken care of.
Wow.
Tell us when we will have these in...
Yeah.
It is now public. The mod is out. I don't know if Slowpoke has a plan to be in the Feed the Beast pack itself, but there's another mod pack that will have it, as well as all the other normal mods.
Oh, those are lovely.
Yeah, they're cute. They're cute little guys. I'll show you some more Thaumcraft stuff, I think, in the next episode here.
I did hit him.
Need my magic wand. Oh, where's he going? He's going around the corner here. He found something to pick up.
He ran away because I hit him, I think. He was hiding.
Oh, you scared him. Yeah, you need a magic wand to turn him back into inanimate golem.
Oh. Oh, now Monkey Farm got it. Run!
Yeah, boy. Where can I put him?
You can attach him to any of it. Just right-click on a chest or something, and he'll live there.
Can you attach it to people?
Nah.
Aw, voodoo.
Look, link me for a good time.
I don't think that's a good time. We'll check out some Thaumcraft stuff in the next episode, I think. Yeah,
we'll do.
Cool, guys.
So thanks a lot, Direwolf. Guys,
sure.
See you next time. I hope you enjoy this tour. I do. It's amazing. And I think it will help you to get a little bit of an overview what's possible with all these mods, right? It's just cool if you see it, if you can really visualize it. It's amazing. Thanks a lot, Dire. It's really cool.
Sure, guys. Thank you.
Yep. And we'll be back.
Cool. All right, guys. Sorry, we'll sign it off. Take it easy.